Every president gets aggressive. They want as much power as they can get. The job of Congress and the courts is, of course, to check that ambition. Now, we have some first problems here, and we need facts first action to deal with them. First, we have a treat for the president on Halloween. What he's doing with the military on the border may be politically arguable, but it is probably legal, all right? Today, the president even upped the ante.
As far as the caravan is concerned, our military is out. We have about 5,000, we'll go up to anywhere between 10 and 15,000 military personnel on top of Border Patrol, ICE, and everybody else at the border.
15,000, that's double the figure that the Pentagon officials said would be operating there. If it does reach that figure, because you never know with the president, if he's just saying it or if it means something, that would be more than our number of troops in Afghanistan, three times the size of our presence in Iraq. It's also true that you had other presidents, Bush and Obama, sent in the military, too, to enforce the border, but not active duty military like Trump is suggesting. They used the National Guard. Same thing? Nope. Governors agreed to send National Guard along with the federal government. All right? They're not even part of that fancy phrase you keep hearing, posse comitatus, which means county force. That law has a restriction on the military doing domestic law enforcement. National Guard's not included in it. That's why you see the National Guard included at riots, but never active duty troops. Bush deployed 6,000 National Guard troops. Obama sent out 1,200 in 2010. But here's something you have to know. Those numbers were much lower, but listen to the price tag. $1.3 billion for both operations. Build a lot of wall for that money. So while expensive and arguably offensive, Trump can probably do it. That's the treat. But what he can't do is what he was trying to sell you today. Listen.
You don't need a constitutional amendment for birthright citizenship. If President Obama can get DACA approved, if you look at DACA, where he actually said, well, this isn't legal or this I can't do, but I'll do it anyway. If he can do DACA, we can do this by executive order.
Nope. Don't be a sucker. First, whether you need one or not, you have a constitutional amendment that deals with birthright citizenship. It cannot be wished or ordered away. And there is no reason for this to go to the Supreme Court. And even when the issue has come before the Supreme Court, as it did many, many years ago, it looked at the issue and made it crystal clear. If you're born here, you're a citizen, period. Now, DACA, now follow what's happening here. That was a presidential power grab. That's how I started this wall for you. That's what presidents do. But it was within an existing framework of legislation. Aggressive by Obama, maybe too aggressive, no doubt about that, but an entirely different animal, legally and logically, from what Trump is trying. DACA was not a move to change what is expressly in the Constitution. Trump's move is. He said his lawyers said he could do this. When we asked to hear from the lawyers, we got nothing. Now, there is a fallback position now with Trump. This often happens. When he gets out over his skis and says something wrong, all of a sudden it meant something else. This isn't about changing the 14th Amendment, although that's exactly what he said. It's really about reinterpreting what was said in light of a new reality with illegal entrance. This is some trick by the Republicans, even on Halloween. Trump and co. have said a million times they want strict constructionists when it comes to the Constitution, right? They want to just stick to the text, especially when it comes to the Supreme Court. That's their argument with the Second Amendment about bearing arms. Don't apply it to now and the realities we have. It only means what it says. And yet now, when it comes to the 14th Amendment, they want the opposite. Don't look at what the framers said. Look at what it means today. They never envisioned this. The idea, as this little runaround, that the phrase, subject to the jurisdiction thereof, changes things. Because illegal people, they're not subject to the jurisdiction, really. Then why can you have ICE round them up like stray cats? The reason you can is because they are subject to your jurisdiction. Lastly, as a matter of fact, Trump's saying today that what he wants to do is okay because that's what Obama did. He hated what Obama did. Listen for yourself.
President Obama signed DACA. When he signed it, he said, I'm really not allowed to sign this, and I'm going to sign it anyway.
President Obama, when he signed the executive order, actually said he doesn't have the right to do this.
And he goes around signing all these executive orders. It's a basic disaster. You can't do it.
So it was wrong, but now it's okay because you want to do the same thing even though you're trying to do something that's totally different. The hypocrisy, the nonsense, it's all too scary, even on Halloween.